Here's a tutorial on how to operate your console. First of all, make sure your louvers are open, otherwise it'll sound muffled and you'll wonder why. I like to angle them out just because you can still see the louvers. It just looks nice. In the back of the unit, make sure you plug it in. There's two things to plug in. Your Bluetooth receiver and then the unit itself. Pop that up. So if you want to simply play the radio. So we got an on-off button there. It says phono auto, power, and radio. Power is just a light. So right now I turned it on, but you don't hear anything. There's six switches here. They're electrostatic. All you gotta do is touch them. And we got the radio. Here's our loudness. If you want it to be stereo, you have to press stereo.
Oh, it's great.
Now it's stereo.
Thank you again.
This is your tuner. If that's too much bass, turn it down. Turn your treble up, your presence or contour control. I like to have that near the top. Balance left and right. Fine-tune that for your listening pleasure. If you want extra bass, press that. Press it again to release it. If you want to use Bluetooth, put it on tape. Then you have to sync up your phone with Bluetooth. Hopefully you know how to do that. If you don't, you got to press... Sorry. There's your Bluetooth receiver there. If you want to sync up your phone, see how there's a blue light in the back? Press this button and hold it till it starts blinking. Now your phone can find it. My Bluetooth is already hooked up to this right now, so I could play a song, but then it won't be in the video. I'm going to press it again just to get it to stop. Well, that doesn't work. But anyway, so that's how you play your Bluetooth. So let's say you want to play a record. The power doesn't have to be on because phono auto means when you turn this on, it will turn the power on to the amplifier. Make sure when you play a record, you set your speed first. And then make sure this isn't locked. So we'll unlock it, set it back down. Always pull your overarm up from back here. Let's grab a record or two. Make sure your needle is inward for playing LPs. Outward for playing 78s. Push this all the way to reject. It'll drop a record and play it. You do have to push phono and stereo. Tired of that record, you want to go to the next one? When it gets to the end of the record, it'll either go to the next record automatically or turn off. Pull this out and put this in. It'd be like a normal turntable. That plastic's not so flexible anymore, so this will just be in the record well. If you ever have to order a new needle, that's the needle you want. 274 DS73. Play a 45 record here in a moment. So it's going to turn off. Always lift from back here. Pull these records off. So if you ever wanted to treat this as a turntable, just pull this out. Set that somewhere. Put that other black piece down in there. And you put it on manual. And then you can use your cue lever, which is back here, to lift it up, slide it over, and place it where you want. So we're going to play 45, so we're going to put it on 45. Got to put our adapter on. Got to put this back in. You see there's a flat spot right here. And there's a flat spot in there too. Just make sure they align. And it clicks in place. Put our 45 adapter on. You see there's a slot that lines up with this side. Grab a couple of 45s for demonstration purposes. Again, turn your phono on, turn your stereo on. Want to go to the next record? And this will turn the amp off automatically, and you don't have to worry about that. The biggest thing you got to remember is when you're playing a record or the radio and you're turning it on for the first time, you have to press your electrolytic switches for whatever it is you want. AFC is so that when you're tuning in between channels, you don't hear static. If you want to hear static, put it down to there. That's it in a nutshell. This little thing here is kind of cool because you can hold on to that and do this. It's a cool little novelty, but it's really unnecessary. Hope you enjoy your new console. Well, your new old console.